On Sunday, February 9th, we watched the Solar Orbiter spacecraft take to the sky on a United Launch Alliance Atlas V rocket.
And it was an absolutely stunning display.
Thousands of people came from all over Europe to watch this launch with us.
We want to get the closest view possible of liftoff. So we had the chance to bring a big telescope with us to the NASA press site. This is a Meade LX200 scope. We work with Tim Dodd, the Everyday Astronaut, and OPT telescopes to set all this up. And basically with the camera that we attached to the back, a 4K slow motion camera, the equivalent field of view is like having a 5,000 millimeter zoom lens.
It's crazy.
So it's super tight on the rocket. Basically, with the screens we bring out, so we have one screen attached to the camera on the telescope. It gives us a really tight view. Basically, we can just see the top of the rocket, so the payload fairing. And at liftoff, things move so quickly, mm-hmm. It's so difficult to track. We need a wider view. So we have a second camera attached to the top of the telescope that has its own screen. And we're basically looking at that wider view back and forth between the tight view, wider view, to have any chance of following this. We have a laptop out there with us that's interpreting the joystick commands. That was all programmed by Scott Ferguson at Astronomy-live. We have behind the scenes cameras recording what we're doing. There's a pocket 4K camera behind us, focused in on the pad, but with us in the view. So we have all this stuff that it takes a while to set up, but once we set it up, then we don't touch it because there's so much excitement as the countdown clock near zero that we just want to be ready to go. So that last moment we hit record on everything and then wait. So as with any launch, we're also recording audio of the liftoff. Mm-hmm. So listen closely to this audio. A few moments after liftoff, you're going to begin to hear this higher pitched kind of echoey screeching noise. And what that is the rumble from the Atlas V, and the sound is echoing and vibrating the panels on the vehicle assembly building, which is probably maybe a half a mile away from us at that point. So we were able to track it with a telescope. We got some great engine footage, and I think one of the most spectacular things is seeing the engines in the sky just before booster engine cutoff. It's sort of this nebula-like starburst pattern in the sky. It's bright. It's partially illuminated by the moon. We got to see a little bit of the exhaust trail, and then just at the moment of booster engine cutoff, there's this pause. It turns into a tiny star, and then there's one more burst of nebula-like light.
go.
Ha ha ha.